Hello there, everyone, and welcome back to my Let's Play of Mega Man X 3, part of the Mega Man X collection. Now then, last time we took on the intro stage and defeated Blizzard Buffalo to get his ability, the Ice Shield. Now then, we take his special weapon and take it to Toxic Seahorse. I'm not gonna go into detail into how that could possibly work, but let's go on through a sewer level. Usually people with sewer levels are like, they're boring. Ugh. But this sewer level is actually kind of fun. I don't know how that's possible, but it is. And I'm just blasting those things apart like it's nothing else. Ah, come on. Yeah, you can't just dash into these cannonballers when you're going uphill, like I've been doing a lot. Seriously, this upwards air dash is really helping me out in these stages. Or is really going to, anyway. Okay, there we go. Alright, we work our way up. You can get that falling energy item, but I really don't care enough. If you keep going up, heart tank. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, so down here we go. Take care of that little bugger. Go through this little door. Which doesn't have a boss because, well, we haven't hit that part in the story yet. And that's how that works, actually, is that you actually have to get to a certain point in the plot before it works. Okay then, we come to another one of these things that we can't do anything with, so we'll ignore it for now. And back into the water we go. Be careful with these baddies because, I can't remember why I have to be careful with them. Other than that their spikes floats upwards. We actually can't do anything with the upper half of the level until we get an upgrade, so that's why I'm not up there. Right now, this boss door, on the other hand, has an actual mini-boss. All you gotta do is just kinda pelt this thing while dodging its missiles. And its mines. Which isn't all that hard, you can just slide yourself underneath him and he doesn't take that many hits. So after this clown that explodes like a normal boss, let's move on. Okay, so now the water's gonna drain from the stage, which actually looks okay, except for the fact that I can see the very bottom there. But anyway, let's keep climbing and we'll be seeing those two particular enemies, the cannonball guys and these guys, throughout pretty much every stage. And there's not a lot of variety here when it comes to those guys. Alright, so now we're on top of the dam. Which I guess is why this sewer level's a little more interesting, is because... Oh, come on! That one was my bad. I should have slid down the wall. That's why blind leaps of faith are generally not such a big deal with this game when it comes to falling, because there's usually a wall that you're supposed to slow down on. Okay, so sliding down carefully, there's a ledge that you could have fallen down to if... Well, actually, come to think of it, it's very, very hard to actually hit the spikes unless you're intentionally going left after you fall. Okay, my bad. Okay, let's use the ice shield. Frost shield, pardon me. I got that wrong the whole stage. Whatever. The frost shield is very effective on Toxic Seahorse. Mainly because you can use it, run away, and he'll jump on it forevermore. But because you guys want to see a boss fight, I'll let him actually do some attacks. Basically, he'll throw He'll throw little balls of acid throughout the stage, and they'll occasionally rain. And sometimes there's some bouncing ones. Although you generally don't want to stay in the air, I don't really see how I'm supposed to dodge that. So, let's just take him with the frost shield, huh? Like I really should have. And because I only have one life left, probably. Although, really, it makes Toxic Seahorse look like a complete and total dumbass. For falling for the same trap like 50 times. He really does like to Mario stomp ya, I guess. I mean, why not? It's a very good strategy, given that he's faster than I am. Okay, so what you saw there, if the frost shield manages to survive after it hits an object, it will actually create a spike that only enemies will get hurt by. It's not very often in a stage where you'd ever get chased by something, it's only bosses, so I have no idea what purpose that serves. But anyway, now we get Toxic Seahorse's Acid Balls of Death, known as the Acid Burst. Well, it's actually a fair name, given that it hits the ground and then explodes. And now a cutscene! Take a wild guess as to who's still alive after being killed like 3 times. So yeah, now we've seen our mid-bosses, and now we also know that Vile is alive again. I'm hoping that you all guessed that was Vile that was in shading, because, that was Vile. Anyway, let's move on to another stage, shall we? And yes, there is still some cleanup to do here, but I lack the required upgrades in order to do that. So, let's move on to Tunnel Rhino. Come to think of it, he never actually does any tunneling when we fight him, so I have no clue. Okay, let's move on, shall we? Okay, first off, you want to go a little slow here, because otherwise you're going to get attacked by the boulders. And as soon as it lands, it's going to shoot a missile, so of course you want to shoot it. Okay, we're far past that, so... Okay, so those dinguses are just... to be in the way, pretty much, if you just shoot them blindly. And I, of course, lack the necessary upgrades to do this, so I can't get it. It's actually two things I lack, which is the arm part and a weapon. Whereas in the last level, I just lacked something else entirely. That I'll get into eventually. Although, a lot of you probably already know what that is if you've played this game before. Okay then, so over here, past all these conveyor belts, another sub-tank. Wait, how many does that make now? That makes two! Okay, just making sure. Okay, so you want to carefully drop in the middle. Probably want to run past it before those things actually get off any shots. By the way, there is absolutely no way to know whether Bit or Bite are going to be in these stages. So, you know. They'll appear when you least expect it. Alright, I don't think there's any chance of something going bad here. So, if you pause, and I forget which button it was, if you push the dash button, and then unpause, you will switch from X to zero. Of course, it takes a little bit of time to load up or something. But yeah, you can play as zero. He will, however, jump ship partway through the level, so don't expect to cheat with him throughout the levels. But yeah, Zero is actually very good at tearing through things quickly. But make sure not to get him killed because he's only got one life. So if there's ever danger of him actually dying, you probably want to swap back. The same way that you swap in the first place. You can only swap once per stage, so you can't call Zero anymore because all it does is have static. So, yeah. Okay then, so up here we go. Well, actually, I was wrong. It was the A button that made Zero come out, but that's besides the point. Which would normally be swapping your... Which would normally... Okay, now it's time for this guy. He's kind of annoying, but he really doesn't do much. He just kind of pecks the wall with his... You know what? This guy is really awkward looking. That's a very unfortunate place to have that spike as he tackles towards you. What kind of image does that set? Seriously? What the hell, Capcom? And then that guy's toast. But seriously, crotch spikes? That's just wrong! Okay, so after that... Okay, that is actually a rather interesting enemy. Come to think of it. It's basically those cannonball guys, except they can fire drills, too. By the way, guess what our weapon from this stage is? You know you want to guess. Because it's pretty much the same thing as those drill enemies, except quite a bit stronger. They even took the time to animate them going through the wall too. That's a nice little detail. I keep thinking there's a way down there, but there's never is. Okay. I've always been hit by those dang drills every time, so I've always had trouble with those. Anyways, over and onwards to Tunnel Rhino. This guy is not particularly hard, although you gotta watch out that he doesn't drill the wall because because if he does drill the wall while you're on it, you're gonna fall down. But luckily, you can jump just high enough to go over him. Ouch. So in short, he's actually shorter than Blizzard Buffalo. I don't know why I keep failing to jump. I keep thinking it's my fault, but it doesn't seem to be. But anyway, he is weak to the acid burst. Which, by the way, can be fired straight up into the air. For whatever reason. And I ran out of lives, so pardon me while I get back here. Aw, man, it's been so long since I played this and I'm forgetting stuff and ramming myself into every enemy I see. And I should have had more to drink today. What was his weakness again? It's probably something I don't have with my luck. Oh, it's this. I really wish it wouldn't use up all of my tank. What, two? Okay, so we've taken out you. So, if you happen to have their weakness weapon when you fight them, they will actually die. Which is of some importance, because if you manage to kill them both, you won't have to fight a specific boss later, but you'll get a different boss. That's what's up with these guys and fighting them now. But I digress. Let's move on. Which can be a bad thing. And I really wish I could dodge this son of a... Oh. What is my problem today? Okay, let's see if I can fight this guy right this time. Because I really hope I do. So yeah, even if you do have this boss's weakness, he's going to be rough. And how I was invincible for that, I have no idea. And how I could have dodged that, I have no idea. But either way, I'm guaranteed to beat this guy now. Just always be ready to jump, because he can't do that. And I finally beat this guy. Wow, this game is a lot harder than I remember. I've just probably had more practice at this game than X2 and then forgot about everything after some time of not playing. But anyway, this guy's weapon is... well... the Tornado Fang. What, did you expect Drill to be in there somewhere? No, it's called the Tornado Fang. Shut up. Anyway, that'll take care of this episode. So, I'll see you all next time when I play some more Mega Man X3. And we'll take on this guy for whatever reason. Later!